Let's discuss the growth and development of the Islamic capital markets. In last couple of years, Islamic capital market is growing tremendously. It has become a huge market in terms of billion of dollars. But it is a gradual increase in stages. In stage one, the study about Islamic finance started in Azerbaijan, China, Hong Kong, Philippines, and Uzbekistan. Then in stage two, it went to Albania, Algeria, Germany, Kazakhstan, Lebanon, Oman, Sri Lanka, Syria, and United States. In stage three, it went to Bangladesh, Brunei, Indonesia, Morocco, Palestine, Qatar, Russia, Singapore, South Africa, Tunisia, and Turkey. Then it went to Egypt, Iran, Jordan, KSA, Pakistan, Sudan, and UAE. And in stage five, in terms of full capital market, Bahrain and Malaysia, these are two countries which are now becoming the role model in terms of Islamic capital markets in the whole world. In stage one, they start beginning to study about Islamic issues. Stage two, they introduce insurance and retail offerings. In stage three, they develop IFIs, like Islamic financial institutions. In stage four, they introduce mutual funds. And in stage five, they introduce the full capital market. This is the growth. Now, in terms of growth, of course, the first concept behind this growth was conventional banking was available. And they were doing pretty good. They were very organized in terms of knowledge, product, featuring customer satisfaction and all that stuff. When it comes to Islamic banking, it developed as a new industry in terms of Islamic financial industry. Then first index, equity index, was introduced in 1996. Then Dow Jones Islamic market index was introduced in 1999, and in Kuala Lumpur it was in April 99. This is how things keep moving. Growth in members was observed, so approximately 3.3 billion was the size over the past 7 years. 150 Islamic equity firms in all over the world. And the growth is around 12 to 15% every year. In 1994, it was 9%. In 2000 till 2005, it is 127% increase over the years. Over the years, a lot of Sharia products were introduced based on market capitalization in terms of equity, bonds, in terms of mutual funds. So these options were being issued to the investors who are really interested in terms of Islamic finance. Then we have equity market screening process were introduced, which was to comply with Sharia. It is mainly observed in Malaysia. Then they introduced like FTSE Islamic Index, Standard & Poor's, a very famous rating company. They introduced the law. They launched in 2007. So it's a gradual focus of the world based on the increasing need. Then a UFI Sharia standard came into by the accounting and auditing organization for Islamic financial institutions. They try to standardize certain things, how to do accounting for Abudhabi, Musharika, Ijari, Salam, Istasniya, and what are different accounting issues in terms of reporting analysis. This is what they take in consideration in general. And then if you see the GCC, GCC we call as Gulf Cooperation for a Council. This is between Gulf countries, mainly they are oil producing countries like United Arab Emirates, Saudi Arabia, Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, Sultanate of Oman, then it covers Kuwait, Qatar, these are all GCC countries. They started, the GDP was in 2000 for Bahrain was 7.9, for Kuwait around 36.88, Saudi Arabia was huge in the 188.44, and in the UAE it was 70.5, and until 2005 if you compare it was almost double growth. Bahrain in 2005 become 12.9, Kuwait become 74, Saudi Arabia become 286, and in UAE, United Arab Emirates, it has become 27.9. These figures were issued from the World Bank statistics, and they are all in, as I told you, in billion dollars. This industry is growing, GCC is growing in terms of economy, GDP, infrastructure, and a lot of Islamic investments are prevalent, and they are really working as the leaders in terms of Islamic finance and products. Market liberalization policies are very much required in terms to liberate the market for free sources about the buying and selling. So these policies were introduced, then they adopt the international best practices. Like in conventional banking we have GIBS, like global investment standards. This is the same as they try to regulate all the industry. One framework, one Islam, one product. This will be a very nice idea. It will let this industry grow all over the world. In certain countries, we have taxations, and we pay taxes when we buy a home, when we invest, we have capital gains. There are certain countries like UK, Malaysia, and Singapore, and a couple of other countries, they try to adjust these tax changes in order to facilitate the Islamic investors. This competition was becoming healthy, and recently, like in 2007, Dubai government appears to be managing over $7 billion of international scope, which is a huge contribution to the Islamic bonds market. If you see, there are so many big companies over the period of time, they issue Sukuk, we have Dana Gas, we have DP World, which is based in Dubai. We have DIFC, the Dubai International Financial Center. We have Bakhtiar Investments. We have Emirates Islamic Bank, Dubai Islamic Bank, Sharjah Electricity and Water Authority, they issue Sukuk. We have in Abu Dhabi based construction largest company is Aldar Properties. So these are so many names in terms of their size and volume, which is contributing towards the Sukuk market, Sukuk bonds, and contributing towards the bond markets in terms of Islamizations. Then, of course, the international agencies' role is very important in terms of growth of Islamic capital markets, because there are a lot of constraints in terms of globalization, harmonization, standardization in terms of accounting frameworks, policies, procedures. IOFI, that is the accounting and auditing organization for Islamic financial institution, they issue standards in terms of 17, standard number 17 is for Sukuk, standard number 20 is for stock commodities, and 21 is for financial papers. You know, there are a lot of lists for the standards which which contributes towards the harmonization. We have Islamic Financial Services Board that is based in Malaysia that was made in 2002, and mainly it was focused on perceived lack of integrated supervision and regulation on unique risk associated with IFI products. Then we can see International Islamic Financial Markets, that is founded by the Central Bank and Monetary Agencies of Bahrain, Brunei, Indonesia, Malaysia, Sudan, and Islamic Development Bank based in Saudi Arabia. Another important framework is given by International Islamic Rating Agency based on the concept they for rating in terms of compliance, other things. It helps bond issuers to improve their categories. There is Liquidity Management Center, which was introduced to manage the global liquidity of the world in terms of Islamic issuance. The role of Islamic Development Bank is really vital, and they address so many issues in terms of Muslim community, Muslim members, and their compliance with the Sharia law and standards in terms of achieving the best results in terms of the good governance.